We completed the chapter electricity. Now we are going to solve the problems given in the textbook. In the public examination is concerned, all these problems are not that much important. But the textbook, they are given these problems only to make you to understand the subject better, and you can use this subject for your future studies. Therefore, I solve these problems one by one, and rest of the problems I get you in the form of printed notes, and you sit and solve these problems. Solving this problem makes you to understand this subject very nicely. It is not an examination point of view. It is mainly because of understanding the subject better. Now we start solving the problems. Name of the chapter is electricity. And before solving the problem, what we have to understand, we have to list out all the formulas what we studied while understanding the chapter electricity theoretically. Theoretical knowledge is very much important to solve the problems. First we go to understand, list out the formula what we studied in this chapter. See, here there are blocks. Each block is hidden by a formula. Now I open one by one. You have to tell, you have to repeat along with me to understand that particular formula. The first formula what you have to remember to solve the problem is I is equal to Q by T. This is the formula that is going to explain about electric current. Electric current is nothing but rate of flow of electric charges. Here I is equal to Q by T means I stands for electric current, Q stands for quantity of charges, T stands for time. Therefore, the first formula is I is equal to Q by T. Second formula is V is equal to W by Q. This formula explains about the potential difference. Potential difference is what? It is the amount of work done to move one unit charge from one point to another point. V is equal to W by Q. Here V stands for potential difference, W stands for work done, Q stands for quantity of charges. Second formula is V is equal to W by Q. The third formula, very important formula for the understanding of chapter electricity, is V is equal to IR. This is the formula related to Ohm's law. This formula tells us how electric current is related to the potential difference. As the potential difference increases, electric current increases. Electric current and potential difference are directly proportional to each other. Or you can understand, instead of potential difference, you can remember it as voltage. As voltage increases, electric current increases. And that is given in the statement of Ohm's law. At constant temperature, potential difference at the ends of the terminals of a conductor is directly proportional to the electric current. V is equal to IR. The next formula we studied in this chapter is R is equal to rho L by A. This tells that which are the factors that are responsible for identifying the resistance. Resistance of a material depends on three factors. One is the length of the wire, A is area of cross section, and rho is the specific resistivity of the material. And R is equal to rho L by A is a very important formula to understand the relation of resistance, right? The next formula is what is the total resistance of the circuit when the resistors are connected in series. RS stands for resistors are connected in series. Total resistance of the circuit when the resistors are connected in series, that is RS. RS is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Like that, if three resistors are there, R1 plus R2 plus R3. If two resistors are there, R1 plus R2. If four is there, R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus R4. Like that, we have to apply the formula to find the total resistance of the circuit. If the resistors are connected in parallel, then the formula is 1 by RP. RP stands for resistors in parallel. Reciprocal of the total resistance of the circuit when the resistors are connected in parallel is equal to sum of the reciprocals of the individual resistances of the resistor. Therefore, 1 by RP is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Here, what we understand is when the resistors are connected in series, total resistance of the circuit increases. When the resistors are connected in parallel, total resistance of the circuit decreases. Therefore, the connecting resistors in series is practically it is impossible. If you connect the resistors in series, the total resistance may increase, the circuit may break down. Therefore, in practical purpose, we always connect resistors in parallel. That I told, I explained while teaching series connection and parallel connection, which one is advantageous, which one we use it for regularly. That is, we are connecting resistance in parallel. That is the idea of these two formula. Now, the next is H is equal to I square RT. This is the formula related to Joule's law of heating. Joule's law of heating is also a very important unit in this particular chapter. H is equal to I square RT. Amount of heat produced in a circuit is directly proportional to the square of the electric current, resistance of the conductor and time. H is equal to I square RT. This H is equal to I square RT formula can be modified as H is equal to VIT, where how we modified I square RT can be written as I into R, where IR is equal to V. Therefore, I replace in the place of IR as V, then we get the formula H is equal to VIT. H is equal to VIT and H is equal to I square RT both can be used to solve the problems related to amount of heat generated in a circuit during the passage of electric current. P is equal to I square R. This is the formula to find the power, electric power. P is equal to I square R, because P is equal to work done by time. Work is nothing but heat. Therefore, P is equal to I square R is the one formula. There are three formulas related to power of electric power. Here, P is equal to I square R. Without knowing the value of V, we can calculate power here. See, V is equal to I square R means I is given, R is given, V is not given. We don't know the value of V. Then also we can find the power. P is equal to IV. It is another formula for calculating power. Here, we can calculate power even resistance is not known to us. Electric current and potential difference is sufficient to calculate the concept of power. P is equal to V square by R. It is our third formula related to the power. Here, I is not known to us. V square by R is help us to get the value of P. Therefore, P is equal to I square R, P is equal to IV, P is equal to V square by R are the formula related to electric power. This ends all the formulas present in this chapter called electricity. You have to remember all the formulas from I is equal to Q by T to P is equal to V square by R. Now we learn the SI unit, because after solving the problem, we have to write the units, you have to write the units of the physical quantities. You have to remember the SI unit. These are the SI units listed in your chapter. I listed out all the SI units listed in the chapter in this particular chart. Electric current, the symbol of electric current is I and the SI unit of electric current is ampere. Symbol of ampere is A. You have to practice this. This is going to fetch you 1 mark. Public examination question paper, definitely they will ask at least one SI unit, right? Quantity of charges, coulomb. The SI unit of quantity of charges is coulomb. SI unit of time is seconds. Always time should be mentioned in seconds. Potential difference, SI unit of potential difference is volt. SI unit of work done is joule. J is the unit. SI unit of resistance is ohm. Ohm is a very important unit you have to remember. Ohm is the SI unit of resistance. SI unit of resistor, resistivity is ohm meter. SI unit of resistivity or rho is ohm meter. SI unit of heat is joule. Therefore, SI unit of work done and SI unit of heat, both are joule. SI unit of power is watt. But SI unit of electric power, here you have to remember commercial unit of electric power, that is kilowatt hour, kWh. Commonly it is called unit. SI unit of electric power is kilowatt hour. Commonly it is called unit. These are all regarding SI unit of physical quantities. Now we know the formulas and SI units. This much you should know. solving problem, I don't think so it is that much important for the examination, because we may get one problem, that a very simple problem we get in the public examination. In the textbook, they are given highly complicated problems. I solve one by one. Understand, concentrate. By that, you can understand the subject better. Now, I solve one by one problems. The first problem is, a piece of wire of resistance R is cut into 5 equal parts. There is a resistance R is cut into 5 equal parts. These parts are connected in parallel. They are connected, these cut 5 equal parts in parallel. If the equivalent resistance of the combination is R dash, if the total resistance of the combination is R dash, then the ratio R by R dash is dash. It is a multiple choice question. These are the options. A 1 by 25, B 1 by 5, C 5, D 25, which is the answer we have to find. Right? We solve like this. Total resistance is given. The total resistance of the wire is 5. And this total resistance is cut into 5 equal parts. Therefore, each division is equal to R by 5. Total resistance is R. That is, divided by 5 means each resistor is equal to R by 5. And these resistors are connected in parallel. If they are connected in parallel, you have to write like this only, because the equation to find the total resistance when the resistors are connected in parallel, that is 1 by R dash is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3 plus 1 by R4 plus 1 by R5. Here R1, R2, R3, R4, R5 are R by 5, because the resistors are cut into 5 equal parts. Therefore, in the place of R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, I have written R by 5, R by 5, R by 5, R by 5, R by 5. Right? The formula or the calculation is like this. Now, 1 by R by 5, when you take in as a reciprocal, it becomes what? 1 by R dash is equal to 5 by R plus 5 by R plus 5 by R, because they go to numerator, it becomes R by 5 becomes 5 by R. Then it becomes 1 by R dash is equal to 5 by R plus 5 by R plus 5 by R plus 5 by R plus 5 by R. Now we have to take the LCM. The LCM is 1 by R dash is equal to the total, all the denominators are R, that LCM is R, the numerator becomes 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5, it becomes 1 by R dash is equal to 25 by R. But he wants R by R dash. You make R by R dash as, you remodulate this particular proportion as R by R dash, denominator by denominator is equal to numerator by numerator, 25 by 1. R by R dash is equal to 25 by 1. 25 by 1 is equal to what? 25. Therefore, 25 is the answer. Therefore, see, D is the answer for this particular question. The total equivalent combination of the resistor is equal to 25. This is a multiple choice question. Try to understand the difficulty level of this particular problem. Your textbook is fantastic. They have made it for both CBSE and State Board. But these questions may not be that much useful for the public examination. But these questions are very important for our future studies, right? This is the first question. It is a multiple choice. It fetches only one mark to solve this. Right, now I go for second question. Second question is, which of the following terms does not represent electric power in a circuit? This is a very simple, easiest question. You have to, if you know the formula for electric power, you can easily answer this particular question. Which are the formula related to electric power? P is equal to I square R, P is equal to IV, P is equal to V square by R. One is not related to the power. Which one is not related to the power? You have to understand. Now see, they are given I square R, I R square, V I, V square R. See, first I list out all the formulas of power. P is equal to I square R. Is it there? So A is that. P is equal to I square R. P is equal to IV. C is P is equal to IV. P is equal to V square by R. That is also there. One is not there as a formula for power, which is that B. You see B, in the B what is there given? I square, I R square. It is not the formula of power. Therefore, the answer is which one is not the formula for among the four? They asked. I R square is not the formula related to power. That we have. That is the answer for this particular question. Remaining three are formula of power. But I R square is not the formula for the power. This is an easy question. This question you can think that you are going to come for your examination. Third question. An electric bulb is rated 220 V. And 100 W. 220 V means what? Potential difference is 220 volts. 100 watts means power is 100 watts. When it is operated in 110 volt, the power consumed will be, the question is very tricky now, it is, there is an electric bulb, it is working in 220 volts and it consumes the power of 100 watts. Suppose if you make that bulb to work in the voltage of 110 volts, what will be the power consumption? That we have to calculate. Whenever they are given a bulb, it becomes a resistor. Resistors are nothing but devices. The electric bulb is a resistor. Therefore, it is having a resistance. Therefore, we have to calculate the resistance of the electric bulb. 220 volt they are given, 100 watt it consumes. Then what is the resistance of electric bulb you have to calculate. Then using that resistance, you have to calculate the power in the second part. See, the first part is V is equal to 220 V, they are given. P is equal to 100 W. What we have to calculate? Resistance we have to calculate. Therefore, we have to use the formula P is equal to V square by R. Why? Because he is given power. P is given. He is given V. We have to calculate R. Therefore, this is the correct formula to find the resistance of this particular, resistance in this particular problem. P is equal to V square by R. Now I substitute. In the place of P, I write 100. In the place of V, I write 220. 220 into 220. Why? V square is equal to V square it is 220 into 220 divided by R. Now by cross multiplication, R is equal to 220 into 220 divided by 100. Now I cancel all zeros, then it becomes R is equal to 22 into 22, that is equal to 484 ohm. Therefore, the resistance of the electric bulb is 484 ohms. A bulb of 484 ohm resistance, when it is operated in 110 volts, what is the power consumption? Again, we have to calculate. See, now we know the resistance and they are given voltage. Again, the same formula, P is equal to V square by R. Now we know the value of R. I substitute that. P is equal to V square. Now the voltage is changed. From 220 to 110 it becomes. 110 into 110 divided by R is 484. Now we can cancel this by 11, isn't it? 11 tens are 11 44s. Again, we can cancel by 11 tens are and 11 fours. And it becomes 10 into 10 divided by 4. I cancel it by 11. 10 into 10 divided by 4. 10 into 10 divided by 4 is 25. 10 into 10 is 100. 100 by 4 is 25. 25 watt. See, this is also one mark question, multiple choice question. This much of working you have to do to solve this particular problem. Here, what is the meaning of this? A bulb consumes 100 watts in 220 volts. The same bulbs consume 25 watts in 110 volts. The bulb consumes 100 watts in 220 volts, but the same bulb is operated in 110 volts. It consumes only 25 watts. That is the answer we calculated. Right? That is the answer for this. The next question is, two conducting wires of same material of equal lengths and equal diameters are first connected in series and then parallel in a circuit. There are two wires. Both are made by same material. both of them having same length, both of them having same diameter, are connected once in series, next in parallel in a circuit. Once in series, once in parallel. For the same potential difference, voltage is also same. See, everything is same. Two wires are there, same material, same length, same diameter, same voltage, but once they are connected in series, next time they are connected in parallel. Now, you have to calculate the ratio of heat produced in series and parallel combination would be. The ratio of heat produced in series and parallel combination would be. Again, it is a multiple choice question. And four options are there. 1:2, 2:1, 1:4. 4:1. This type of problems are very important for the students who wanted to take NTSC examination. See, SLC, during SLC time, you can take NTSC examination, National Talent Search Examination. Once you take that NTSC examination, you get scholarships. From the scholarship, you can go for higher studies easily. You can learn by using scholarships given from the government, right? That examination is conducted by the Department of Education, and for that one you can ask your school people when is the NTSC examination, where to give application form, everything you can ask. In the NTSC examination, this type of questions are going to come, not for the SLC examination, right? But it is given in the textbook, therefore I am solving this. Now see, two material means, let the resistance be R. We consider the resistance of the material is R. When resistors are connected in series, we know the formula. RS is equal to two resistors, two connecting wire that hold. I made one resistor as R. Therefore, two resistors, they are equal. Therefore, RS is equal to R1 plus R2. That is a formula. But R1 and R2 are equal. Therefore, I write R plus R. RS is equal to 2R. Therefore, when the resistors are connected in series, total resistance is equal to 2R. Right? Total resistance is equal to 2R. We have calculated resistance. Two connecting wires are there. Same material, equal length, equal diameter, same potential. Therefore, when they are connected in series, the total resistance becomes 2R. If they are connected in parallel, what happens? The formula changes. 1/R2 is equal to 1/R1 plus 1/R2. That is the formula for parallel connection. Now, R in the place of R1 and R2, write R. Take LCM. Then 1/R2 is equal to 2/R you get. R2 is equal to R/2. R2 is equal to, you have to take it reciprocal. R/2. When the resistors are connected in series, total resistance is equal to 2R. When the resistors are connected in parallel, total resistance is equal to R/2. Now, formula to find the ratio of heat you have to calculate. Therefore, the formula to find the heat is H is equal to I square RT. Now, we have to find the ratio of heat in series to heat in parallel. Heat in series is to heat in parallel. H is equal to, the formula is I square RT. In the series, in the place of R, I should write 2R. In the place of heat in parallel, in that place, in that case, R, in the place of R, I should write R/2. Therefore, the formula is H is equal to I square RT. The series, in the place of R, I return 2R because total resistance is 2R. In the case of parallel, in the place of R, I written R/2 because total resistance I calculated as R/2. Now you remove the common factors. I square common, TT common, RR common, then what is left? 2:1/2. 2:1/2 is same as 4:1. 2:1/2 is same as what? 4:1. Therefore, the answer is 4:1 is the answer. This is the answer for this particular question. This is a, again, it is a multiple choice question. You have to work it and then find the answer for this particular question. See, this is the easy question. This is the question of public examination. How is a voltmeter connected in circuit to measure the potential difference between the two points? It's very simple. We have only two instruments. One is voltmeter, another one is ammeter. Ammeter is connected in series. Voltmeter is connected in parallel. Always, voltmeter should be connected in parallel. Voltmeter measures potential difference. It is connected in parallel. Suppose if this question is changed as, how is ammeter is connected in the circuit? Ammeter is connected in series. You have to write here. He asked for voltmeter, therefore voltmeter should be connected in parallel. Next question. A copper wire has a diameter 0.5 mm and resistivity 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 8 ohm meter. What will be the length of this wire to make its resistance 10 ohms? The question is very long, very lengthy, and answer is also very lengthy. See, what he is asking is, a copper wire has a diameter 0.5 millimeter and its resistivity is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 8 ohm meter. What will be the length of this wire to make the resistance 10 ohms? Means you have to find the length. Totally what you have understood in this problem is, you have to find the length. Resistivity is given. Resistivity symbol is rho. Therefore, the formula what we are going to use is R is equal to rho L by A. In that formula, we have to find the L. That is the gist of this particular problem. And one more problem is also there. One more statement also there. How much does the resistance change if the diameter is doubled? If you double the resistance, you double the diameter, the resistance is going to change. How much it changes, that also we have to find. First, we listed out the given part. Given, diameter is equal to 0.5 millimeter is given. Resistivity is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 8 ohm meter. Resistance is 10 ohms given. You have to find the length. Again, see children, I am repeating, this type of problems are very useful for the case when you wanted to take NTSC examination. For regular SLC examination, this type of problems are not that much important, depending on the blueprint is concerned, right? Now, the formula, since the resistivity is given, we have to find the length. The formula is R is equal to rho L by A. This is the formula we have to use. R is equal to rho L by A. In this formula, what we have to calculate? We have to calculate L. Therefore, to calculate L, we modify the formula. L is equal to Ra by rho. L is equal to Ra by rho. This is the formula we have to use. Now first we have to find R. R means what? Resistance. They are given. Resistance is 10 ohms. Simple. A is given. A is area of cross section. Area of a circle you have to calculate. Rho is given. Rho is given as 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 8. Now the only thing is we have to find the area. A. Area of a circle is equal to pi r square, because wire, when you cut the wire, the lateral section looks like a circle. Area of a circle it is. Area of a circle formula what? A is equal to pi r square, r square. But he is given diameter. That two diameter is millimeter is given, but all the other measurements are in meter. Therefore, the first step is this millimeter should be converted into meter. It should be converted into meter. Because all the units should be in the same. Diameter is equal to 0.5 mm. First a millimeter, I make it as centimeter. 0.05 centimeter. Then I make it as a meter. You know, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter. Using that, the 0.5 millimeter is converted into 0.0005 meter. Now I write in the scientific notation. Diameter is equal to 5 into 10 to the power of minus 4 meter. This is the diameter of that wire. But I don't know. Area of a circle is equal to pi r square. Therefore, I want radius, not diameter. Therefore, radius is half of the diameter. Diameter is 5. Then radius is equal to 2.5. Half of 5 is 2.5. 2.5 into 10 to the power of minus 4 meter. radius I understood. Now I want to find the area. A is equal to pi r square. Here the place of pi, instead of writing 22 by 7, we can use 3.14. See children, in higher studies, in the place of pi, instead of writing 22 by 7, we write in the decimal number. So 22 by 7, pi is nothing but 22 by 7. Instead of writing 22 by 7, we write 3.14, to second decimal, 3.14. Therefore, I write like this. A is equal to pi, in the place of pi, 3.14. In the place of r, 2.5 into 10 to the power of minus 4 whole square, pi r square. It becomes 3.14 into 2.5 square is 6.25. 10 to the power of minus 4 into 10 to the power of minus 4 is equal to 10 to the power of minus 8. This is the area. Now we understand, calculated the area. We know the resistance, that is 10 ohms. We know the resistivity. Apply all those things in the equation. L is equal to Ra by rho. L is equal to Ra by rho. I got it by the formula. R is equal to rho L by A. Now I substitute. L is equal to 10 into 3.4 into 6.25 into 10 to the power of minus 8 divided by 1.66 into 10 to the power of minus 8. Here 10 is resistance, 3.14 into 6.25 into 10 to the power of minus 8 is the area, 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 8 is the rho value. Now we can easily understand both the cases. We have 10 to the power of minus 8. We can cancel that. It becomes 10 into 3.14 into 6.25 divided by 1.6. You simplify this. You know how to simplify this. Since you are thinking of going for NTSC examination, you cancel this. You get L is equal to 122.66 meter. That is the length of the wire required to get the resistance of 10 ohms if the resistivity of the material is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 8 ohm meter. This type of problems are useful for NTSC examination. What is the full form of NTSC? National Talent Search Examination. It is a national wide examination. SLC students, they take, if a student wants to think about going for engineering or medicine, they think about taking the NTSC examination. In such children, this type of problems are important. But our public examination, I don't think so it is important. Now, next question. See, in that question, there is one more problem was there. How much does the resistance change if the diameter is double? Suppose, imagine a situation, a wire is there. If the wire's thickness is doubled, diameter is doubled, what happens to the resistance? When the thickness doubles, resistance decreases. Resistance and diameter are inversely proportional to each other. You know the formula. R is equal to rho L by A. Diameter and resistance required to calculate A. A is in the denominator. Therefore, resistance is inversely proportional to the area. Therefore, as the area increases, resistance decreases. Diameter double means area increases. Therefore, resistance has to be decreased. How it decreases, we have to understand. For that one, you have to understand the formula of area. Area formula is, area of a circle is equal to pi r square. Imagine a situation. Diameter is doubled means radius is also doubled. Therefore, in the place of r, I should write 2r square, because radius is doubled, pi into 2r whole square. On simplification, we can say that A is equal to pi into 4r square. Therefore, the denominator you get 4. If you replace, in the place of A as pi 4r square, denominator you have a number 4, numerator 1. Therefore, if diameter doubles, resistance decreases by 1/4. The 4 comes to the denominator. Therefore, it is 1/4 of the initial resistance. Suppose, imagine a situation, the resistance of the wire is 40 ohms, and if the diameter of the wire doubled, the resistance of the wire decreases to 10, 1/4. If diameter doubles, resistance decreases by 1/4 of the initial resistance. That you have to understand. Double means it is square, it becomes. Double means 2, 2 square is 4. That much decreases. Now we go for the next problem. This is a problem of graph. The values of current I flowing in a given resistor of the corresponding value of potential difference V across the resistors given below. Here he is telling us to plot a graph. He is given I in amperes, 0.5, 1, 2, 3, 4, that is the value of I current. V 1.6, 3.4, 6.7, 10.2, 13.2 are potential difference. Plot a graph between V and I. Calculate the resistance of that resistor. I told you while teaching, there is a graph called VI graph. Potential difference to electric current graph. That graph is always a linear graph. You get a straight line graph. When you plot potential difference and electric current, you always get a straight line. Therefore, it is called a linear graph. Using that linear graph, we can find the resistance. That is our main theme of Ohm's law. George Simon Ohm, a German scientist, he able to state Ohm's law by plotting this type of graphs. Therefore, it is an application type, right? To write a graph, what we require x coordinate and y coordinate. X coordinate representing voltage, y coordinate representing electric current in this diagram. Now I put a marking. See, in the x-axis, you see 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. They are all voltages, voltage. Because in the values, 1.6, 3.4, 6.7, 10.2, 13.2. Those numbers are there. Therefore, I made it 2, 4, 6, 8 like that. And the y-axis representing electric current. In the y-axis, I have written 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Because in the values, you see the values 0.5, 1, 2, 3, 4. Correctly, it is given. Therefore, I written 1, 2, 3, 4. X-axis is voltage, y-axis current, and this is called VI graph. Now, we plot. The first value is when electric current is 0.5. Try to understand where is 0.5. It is less than 1. In the see the y-axis, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is there. There you have to identify the place of 0.5 and the voltage is 1.6. Where is the position it is? See, this is the position. In this, see the red star. See the red star, that is the point of 0.5 and 1.6 voltage. Now the second one is 1 and 3.4. Current is 1. Voltage is 3.4. 3.4 is less than 4. The next is 2 and 6.7. 2 and 6.7. The next is 3 and 10.2. You know how to plot the graph. And the next I, 4 and 13.2. 4 and 13.2. Now I plot, I join these points. All these points I given to join. What type of graph I should get? I should get a linear graph. I told you in the class, linear means straight line. I get a straight line graph. This is the actual concept of Ohm's law. This way you have to plot a graph. Always you have to get a straight line graph. In this straight line graph, what you have to do is, you have to pick two points. Any two points. See, I pick the second point and the fourth point. Second point is at 3.4 and the fourth point is at 10.2. You also see the value. See, value there, he is given 5 values. Out of the 5 values, I plotted all the 5 values. But now I picked only 2 values. Any 2 values you can take. I taken the first, second value and the fourth value. Second value is 3.4 and fourth value is 10.2. This is 3.4. And this is 10.2, that to take. The same way, corresponding value of electric current you have to take. 3.4 is for the 1 and 10.2 for the value 3. Now 3 minus 1, 3 minus 1 is 2. In the y axis I get 2. In the x axis the difference is 3.4 to 10.2. You have to subtract. You have to subtract 3.4 from 10.2. You get the value of V. You have to subtract 3 by 1 to get the value of I. Because Ohm's law is related to V is equal to IR. Here we have to calculate the resistance. Resistance is equal to V by I. In the graph, V value is 10.2 minus 3.4. I value is 3 minus 1 is 2. Now subtract. 10.2 minus 3.4 is 6.8 by 2. R is equal to 3.4 ohm. R is equal to 3.4 ohm. Therefore, we calculated the resistance using graph. Really higher order problem it is. You have to practice this type of problems. You have to practice. 10th standard students have to practice all these things. Because this type of problems definitely going to help you in your future classes. Right? In the higher classes, this type of problems are going to come. But examination, SLC, our SLC is concerned. This standard is very high for them. Right? Now, the concept is, try to understand, V I graph means potential difference and electric current graph is always a linear graph. Using the linear graph, we can find the resistance. After completion of the trigonometry, we can solve this problem using trigonometry also. Right, the next problem. When 12 volt battery is connected across unknown resistor, there is a current of 2.5 milliampere in the circuit. Find the value of the resistance of the resistor. See what all is given. Once you have analyzed the problem, easy it is. 12 volt battery means voltage is given. Current is given. Current symbol is I. What you have to find? You have to find the resistance. V is given, I is given, resistance you have to calculate. V, I, R. Which formula it is? Ohm's law. First we write the given, V is equal to 12 volt, I is equal to 2.5 milliampere. This is a, again he is given a milliampere, it should be converted into ampere. You know, 1 milliampere is equal to how many amperes? You know, 1 milliampere is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 ampere. You have to substitute that. 2.5 into 10 to the power of minus 3 ampere, you have to write. Milli is given. You have to calculate the resistance value. V is equal to IR. R is equal to V by I. R is equal to V by I. I already told you, I is equal to 2.5 means you have to write 2.5 into 10 to milli. In the place of milli, you have to write 10 to the power of minus 3. Then only you can get the answer. V is equal to 12 is given, state number. I is equal to 2.5 milliampere, 2.5 into milli is 10 to the power of minus 3. Now, see, 10 to the power of minus 3 is there. If I put it to the numerator, if I shift it to the numerator, it becomes R is equal to 12 into 10 to the power of 3, it becomes 10 to the power of minus 3, it becomes 10 to the power of 3 by 2.5. 10 to the power of 3 means 1 followed by 3 zeros. Now, you can simplify this. It becomes 12 into 400, because 1 0 if you remove it becomes 25, 100 by 25, if you remove that one it becomes 400, that becomes R is equal to 4800 ohm. That is the answer for this particular question. Right, to remove 1 0 you have to put a 0, then it becomes 1 more 0, 25 by 10,000 becomes R is equal to 12 into 400, R is equal to 4800 ohm. That is the answer for this particular question. These questions are not that difficult. When you apply your mind, you can easily solve. But when you are able to solve, I tell you, you are a 95% student. Next is, a battery of 9 volt is connected in series with resistors. 0.2 ohm, 0.3 ohm, 0.4 ohm, 0.5 ohms and 12 ohms respectively. How much current would flow through 12 ohm resistor? What is telling is there is a battery. voltage of the battery is 9 volts. It is connected to how many resistors? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 resistors of different resistances in series. Now we have to find the current in 12 ohm resistor given. V is equal to 9 volt, simple. R1, first resistor is 0.2 ohms, second one is 0.3, third one is 0.4, fourth one is 0.5, fifth one is 12 ohms. There are 5 resistors. They are all connected in series. When they are connected in series, the formula is RS is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus R4 plus R5. Write all the values. Add them. You get the total resistance in series. That is 13.4 ohm. Now what happened? He is given V. We calculated R. Now find V is equal to, apply V is equal to IR and find the value of I. I is equal to V by R. Substitute. I is equal to 9 by 9. They are given V is equal to 9 volts. Resistance we calculated as 13.4. Substitute that. Decimal number is there. Make it 90 by 134. On simplification, you get the value I is equal to 0.67 ampere. The current is 0.67 ampere. So if you read this problem, there is a trick in this. All the resistors are connected in series. We know that when the resistors are connected in series, the total current remains the same. Current doesn't change at all. Therefore, we can't practically use series connection because all the devices get same amount of current. In this case, what happened? I is equal to 0.67 ampere means, since they are all connected in series, all these resistors getting same amount of current. Therefore, he is asked a question, how much current would flow through 12 ohm resistor? In series connection, electric current is constant for all the resistors. Therefore, 12 ohm resistor also gets the same amount of current, that is 0.67 amperes. That is the answer for this particular question. The next one is, how many 176 ohm resistors in parallel are required to carry 5 ampere on 220 volt line? See, there is a line of 220 volts, 5 amps current it is carrying. Now we have a resistance of 176 resistors, ohm resistors. We have to connect them in parallel. Try to understand, when the resistors are connected in parallel, total resistance decreases. But one resistor is 176 ohm. They are all connected in parallel. How many such resistors should be connected? That we have to calculate. See, for that one, what we do is, the given part is, I is equal to 5 ampere, V is equal to 220 volts, each resistor is 176 ohm. Forget about the resistors, that 176 ohm, forget about that. What is the actual resistance of the circuit? First you calculate by using the formula V is equal to IR. Because we know the value of I, that is 5 amps. We know the value of V, that is 220 volts. Calculate the R. What is the total resistance of the circuit that we have to calculate before venturing into finding the each resistance, right? Then V is equal to IR means R is equal to V by I. Substitute the value, R is equal to 220 by 5. 220 by 5 means R is equal to 44 ohm. Total resistance of the circuit is 44 ohms. But in this circuit, there are resistors. Each resistor is 176 ohm. They are all connected in parallel. Therefore, we are connecting 176 ohm resistors in parallel to get the total resistance as 44 ohms. Therefore, the number we call like this. Let the number of resistors be X. How many resistors are there? We don't know. But we know the resistance of each resistor. Resistance of each resistor is 176. How many such resistors are there? We don't know. That we have to calculate. I call that as X. Therefore, the formula becomes 1 by 44, 1 by 44 means total resistance is 44, is equal to 1 by 176 plus 1 by 176 plus 1 by 176 plus dash dash dash. How many such resistors are there? X resistors are there. See, resistors are connected in parallel, but the total resistance should be equal to 44. Resistance of each resistor is 176. Therefore, the formula is, according to the formula of parallel connection, 1 by RP is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3 plus dash 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 dash. Total resistance is 44, therefore it becomes 1 by 44 is equal to 1 by 176 plus 1 by 176 plus 1 by 176 plus dash 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 X resistor. Since it is having X resistor, if you take LCM as 176, numerator you get X. 1 by 44 is equal to X by 176. On simplification, cross multiplication, 44X is equal to 176. X is equal to 176 by 44, X is equal to 4. Therefore, 4 resistors of 176 are connected in parallel to get the total resistance as 44 ohm. You have to connect 4 resistors of 176 ohm in parallel to get the total resistance of the circuit as 44 ohms. Slightly difficult problem. Practice this. I tell you, these problems you may not get for the public examination. This problem why I am solving is, they are given in the textbook. The textbook is made for both state and CBSE children. Many CBSE children, they take NTSC examination. State board children also take NTSC examination. For those people, it is very helpful. This solving of this problem is very helpful. What is the full form of NTSC? National Talent Search Examination. It is an examination for scholarships, national scholarships. Now, how you would connect 3 resistors, each of resistance 6 ohm, so that the combination has a resistance of 9 ohms and 4 ohms. Boy, fantastic question it is. They are given 6 ohm resistor, how many? See, they are given 3 resistors. 3 resistors are given. Each resistor is having a resistance of 6 ohm. You have to connect in such a manner to get the total resistance as 9 ohms. In the first problem, 9 ohms. In the second problem, you have to get 4 ohms. See how nice it is. See, you are given 3. 6 ohm, 6 ohm, 6 ohm. 3 resistors are given. Now, you have to connect it. You have to connect. You know the connection like series connection, parallel connection. But the total resistance should be 9 ohm in the first case, 4 ohm in the second case. Now, I explain it like this. Suppose if I connect these 3 resistors in series, then the total resistance becomes 18 ohms, isn't it? 6 plus 6 plus 6, because when the resistors are connected in series, then Rs is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. You have to add the resistors, 6 plus 6 plus 6. If you add all the 3, you get 18. Listen, therefore, this is not the answer. We can't connect them in series. If we connect them in series, you get the total resistance as 18 ohms. But how much he wants? He wants 9 in the first one and 4 in the second one. Therefore, series connection is out of question. Suppose if I connected in like this, parallel. When I connect it in parallel, the formula is 1 by 6 plus 1 by 6 plus 1 by 6. Because when the resistors are connected in parallel, we have to write 1 by RP is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Therefore, it becomes 1 by 6 plus 1 by 6 plus 1 by 6. If you take LCM, 6 is the LCM, 1 plus 1 plus 1, it becomes 3 by 6, 1 by 2. Therefore, the total resistance is equal to 2. This is also not the answer. Why? Because he wants 9 in the first case, 4 in the second case. They are given only 3. You know only 2 ways of connecting. One is series connection, another one is parallel connection. But he is asking you to get the total resistance as 9 ohms. Therefore, we can't simply connect it in the form of series or parallel. Then how we are going to connect? That is the fantastic question. It is real application type. How to connect? See, the solution is like this. What I do is, I connect like this. See, 3 are given, 3 resistors of 6 ohm are given. I connect like this. two resistors are in parallel, first I connect. Then that parallel is connected to with the 6 ohms in series. Now it becomes combination of connection. We have both series and parallel now. Like this, if you connect, what happens? We calculate the total resistance of this particular combination. For that one, first we think about when two resistors are connected in parallel, what happens? 1 by R is equal to 1 by 6 plus 1 by 6, isn't it? 1 by 6 plus 1 by 6. Take the LCM. It becomes 6, 1 plus 1, 2 by 6 is equal to 1 by 3. 1 by R is equal to 1 by 3, therefore R is equal to 3. This complete part becomes 3 ohms. Again, you have to remember, when resistors are connected in parallel, the total resistance decreases. Two resistors of 6 ohms are connected in parallel, the effective resistance becomes 3. Now it becomes 3. The total 6 plus 6 is not 12 in the case of parallel. 6 plus 6 is 3 in the case of a parallel. Now we have two resistors now at present. Think about two resistors. The red colored box circle having two resistors of 6 ohm connected in parallel, but their total effective resistance becomes 3. That 3 and the next one 6. 3 plus 6 is 3 plus 6 is 9 ohms. Therefore, to get 9 ohm resistors from 3 6 ohm resistors, you have to connect two resistors in parallel and one resistance in series to get the 9 ohm resistance. Fantastic questions it is. It is an application type of questions. In higher order education, you get this type of questions. Therefore, enjoy the problem. Try to understand. Three resistors are given. I can't connect it in series. If I connect it in series, it becomes 18. If I connect it in the parallel, it becomes 2. But what combination I have to do? Because we know only two series and parallel. In such cases, what I did is, I connected two resistors in parallel and then one resistor in series. By that, what happened? When two resistors are connected in series of 6 ohm, the total effective resistance becomes 3. 3 plus 6 is, because these two are connected in series, 3 plus 6 is equal to 9. That is the answer for the first one. Now he wants the total resistance as 4 ohms. What combination I can do? I am having only 3 resistors. What combination I can do? 3 resistors are given, 6 ohm, 6 ohm, 6 ohm. Now you connect in whatever manner you wanted to connect, but total resistance should be 4 ohms. What way do you connect? Think. In this case, what we have to do is, two resistors we connected in series. In the previous one, we connected two resistors in parallel and third one is in series. Now what we do is, two resistors in series and third one is in parallel. Like this we connect. When you connect like this, what happens? When the first two resistors are in series, therefore when two resistors are in series, you have to add them. 6 plus 6 it becomes. 6 plus 6 it becomes 12. Therefore this part becomes 12 ohms. Now we have two resistors. One is 12 ohms. Combination becomes 12. 12 ohms and 6 ohms. And these two are connected in parallel. Therefore you have to apply the formula which apply. Formula, that is 1 by R is equal to 1 by 12. Plus 1 by 6. 1 by 12 plus 1 by 6. Take the LCM. 12 is the LCM. 1 plus 3. 3 by 12 is equal to 1 by 4. Therefore, R is equal to 4 ohms. Therefore, to get total resistance as 4 ohms, you have to, from the 6 ohm resistors, you have to connect two resistors in series, and that combination should be connected with the 6 ohms. With parallel, you get the effective voltage as effective resistance as 4 ohms. These type of problems are very useful for problems if you are thinking of taking NTSC examination. Otherwise, this type of problems are not that important for public examination skills. Right?